Dr. Krau, thank you so much for donating your time for this interview. I really appreciate
it. Sure, my pleasure.
I'm in awe with all the before and after pictures that I've seen on our CG Instagram. It's unbelievable the work that you have performed here. One thing that really caught my eyes are the rhinoplasties that you have performed. The before and after pictures are amazing, and I myself want to get one done, but I've been afraid for a very long time. I believe you see a lot of patients that have fear of modifying their faces too.
Sure.
So I'm going to start by asking you, who is a good candidate for a rhinoplasty?
Well, almost anyone that really wants to have their nose changed is, is a candidate. As long as they have realistic expectations.
Right.
I mean, if someone comes in with a request that I feel is really not appropriate, they want to make changes that I personally don't believe are going to be aesthetically improved.
Right.
An improvement, rather, then that's not a good candidate.
Right.
Because, first of all, a few things. You need to have realistic expectations.
Right.
The patient has to have good aesthetics for what they're looking for. And if their aesthetics doesn't match my aesthetics, it's really not a good combination.
Right.
That's what probably the patient that you want to turn down and not operate on.
Mm-hmm.
But and that's a rare. That's really rare. You know, most patients have their act together. They know exactly what they want changed with their nose, and as long as it jives with what I see,
and
then we do it. Now, of course, there are some patients that are not good candidates. Certain patients that may have very thick skins that we can't achieve the results that they're looking for. But that's also the extreme and rare.
I see. So I'm a person that I'm constantly on Instagram, and I see models with beautiful noses, and sometimes I wish that I could get and have that nose. So would you try to change my perspective, or would you recommend what would be better, or you would just turn me down completely?
Well, no, as long as, you know, if you're looking for a particular... As a general rule, it's probably not a great idea to bring someone else's nose and try to get that nose to fit your face.
I see.
You know, most of the times we're working with what we have.
Right.
So you have beautiful features, and let's talk about you since you brought you up, yourself up. There are certain changes which I predict you're looking to change. Probably your bridge, you probably want to take that down, straighten that out a little bit. Maybe the chin itself, you want to rotate that up somewhat and make it a little bit narrower.
Yes.
And that's probably all you need to do, right? So, I mean, if you came to me with those requests, and I agree with those changes, and it sounds like you do too, then you're a great candidate to have that done.
Awesome. Doctor, what is the step-by-step? How would it work once, let's say that I'm watching this interview, and I'm like, okay, so I decided I want to do it with Dr. Krau. Mm-hmm. What is the step-by-step once they go to the clinic?
So, there's a preoperative evaluation. I'll schedule an appointment for me to evaluate the patient, and we're going to go through what we discussed. And again, I'll assess the patient whether she or he is a good candidate for rhinoplasty. They'll assess if I'm the right surgeon for them, and if the two meet, then we schedule the surgery.
Great. How long does it take to recover from such a surgery?
So it depends what you mean by recovery. I mean, the final result sometimes can take 6 months to a year to see, especially on the tip, especially if someone's got thick skin. But really at 1 month, you're almost, as a general, you're probably 80% there. So the first week you're going to have a splint on because we need to stabilize the bones until they heal. You take that off in a week. The nose looks fairly what it's going to look like in a week, but there's many changes going to continue to occur. But as I said, every day, better and better. And in 1 month, generally speaking, you're 80% there.
That's amazing. When would a person be able to get back to work?
So listen, if the patient doesn't mind going to work with a splint on, then they can go to work soon after surgery. But that's unusual. So probably patients go back to work or school, what have you, usually a week after surgery.
Great.
When the splint comes off.
How long do you take to perform such surgery?
It varies. I mean, it can go from anywhere from just 15 minutes to as long as a couple of hours, depending how extensive the reconstruction is. On secondary rhinoplasty, revision rhinoplasty, they're usually more difficult because a lot of times we have to correct things that were done improperly or the patient didn't heal well previously, and that's a little bit more difficult.
Okay.
Unless there are just subtle changes that one wants to achieve in a secondary rhinoplasty.
Mm-hmm.
But on the average, it takes about 45 minutes to do.
Great. What is the number one question that you get from people wanting to get a rhinoplasty?
They want to know if we can achieve the changes that they're looking for,
mm-hmm.
And if they're a good candidate, just like you asked previously.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, there's always fear with doing something that's on your face, right?
Right.
I mean, we do a lot of surgeries here. I pretty much do all the breasts and the breast lifts and rhinoplasty
mm-hmm.
at the clinic. So I guess patients are a little bit more reluctant when
mm-hmm.
it comes to noses because it's going to be always there, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's right in the middle of their face. And it's important to pick the right surgeon to do that.
Right.
Not every surgeon that comes out of training becomes a good rhinoplasty.
Right, right.
Everyone's got their niche, everyone's got their interests and their talents,
mm-hmm.
and that's one of mine. So, like you said, it's important to look at before and afters.
Right, right.
And pick a surgeon with experience that can, that you like the results that they produce.
Right. And talking about experience, how long have you been performing rhinoplasties?
So I've been in practice now for 25 years, so
wow.
Performing rhinoplasties for that length of time. Obviously, in the beginning, I didn't do that many, but now I'm probably doing 250 rhinoplasties a year.
Oh, wow, incredible. Well, I'm sure that I'm in good hands, and I'm sure that all of our followers on Instagram and Facebook would absolutely love to come and meet you and see if they are good candidates. And perhaps to schedule them the surgery with you. Thank you so much, doctor.
Okay.
I really
Great.
Appreciate
Great
it.
You.
Thank
you.
You
too.
So you guys know what to do. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Follow us right now. Write us questions. Whatever you need, comment, like, and follow us. You'll see us every day.
Yeah.